All right, well, here we are, ta-da, live. I am going to be, as you can see, if you actually look at the title here, I don't know if there's actually anyone in the chat yet, but I just fired things up. But I'm gonna be cracking some packs and trying my hand at Hearthstone Constructed. I actually have not played, well, that's not true. I have played Hearthstone Constructed before. I actually played a little bit in my friend Brooks's account when I was in Atlanta for the Magic Grand Prix. And it actually that actually sort of reinvigorated my interest in messing around with Hearthstone, because between the fact that, you know, the constructed decks actually seemed like they were, you know, kind of interesting, and there was, you know, some texture to them compared to a lot of the arena decks, which I feel like are pretty similar a lot, you know, and the fact that there is, you know, a world championship tournament with a lot of money on the line, felt like something that was a that was worth playing. So I wanted to give it a try at least. So. First things first, though, I'm going to fire up some music because, well, I like to listen to music because it's sweet. So we're going to go with podcast. We're going to go with the latest Tritonal podcast. I don't know. Let me know. I've been messing a little bit with my my volume, so let me know how my music compares to my mic at this point. I know that some people were having trouble with it before, but I just wanted to, you know, actually get things going here, so. Alright, so. I actually have not, like, opened any packs on, like, since beta, basically. I haven't actually opened a single pack, so that's why I have 55 packs from, you know, all of the arenas that I've been doing and such, so let's get to it, shall we? I'm gonna open this pack. The pack opening thing's actually kind of sweet. Like, it's sort of tedious opening a bunch of them at once, but you know, we've got a lot to go through. So let's start. Boom. I don't know. Boom. Let's get this one. Boom. 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 That pack was really lame. Boom. Alright, next pack. Come on, come on, come on. Boom! They like a different glow if they're a different rarity, right? Ooh, this one's special, I can tell. Boom! Oh, the card kind of sucks, though. Boom, 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 boom. Ooh, I got a... Oh, hey! Well, we're starting things off well. Get a legendary in our second pack. And like the most popular one in most decks too, I think. All right. Next. Dun 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 dun. Boom. What do we got? Ooh, that's an epic. Ooh, two epic, double epic pack. All right, what do we get? Quality, man, you're lame. Mana Tide Totem's kind of lame. All right. Well, this is you know, off to a good start. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Boom. What do we got? We got anything sweet? All right. Lame, 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 lame. Oh, rare versus epic. Yeah, I'm actually colorblind and can't tell blue from purple, so it makes this kind of complicated. These are all lame. Oh no, I just didn't see that one. All right, lame, 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 lame. Boom. Lame, all lame. Oh, oops, my chat is hidden by my game. Let me, here, sorry. It's screen region right next to my game. Lame, 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 lame. Ooh, a gold. I can disenchant that. Yes. Boom, boom. Lame. Oh. Ooh, epic. Sweet, sweet. Boom, 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 boom. Nothing good. What are you saying, RIP gold cards? What are you talking about? Nothing sweet. Boom. Lame, 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 lame. Boom. Nothing sweet. Boom. A gold card, all right. Boom. Ooh, an epic, all right. Come on, something sweet. Ooh, a gold card. All right, some rares, at least. Anything good? No, nothing sweet. Lame. Lame! Boom, 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 boom. Alright. 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 This guy's so lame. This card is like the lamest card. It's like a 5-3 with combo that isn't even pretty. Like, every time I have this in, like, Arena, it makes me so sad. Like, because it's often just the best card in a pack that has, like, Alarmo bots and shit. Lame. Lame pack, lame pack. Alright, alright. Just got these guys pretty good. Come on, boom. I gotta hover over them again so I see if I get a legendary. It worked last time. Ooh, there's a good one. Lame. Alright, that didn't work. I'm just gonna open them again. No, that was lame. Nothing cool at all. Nothing cool at all. Ooh, I got a Power Blast. I had 3 Power Blasts in an Arena deck the other day. I think I actually had 11 wins. It was either 10 or 11 wins with my 3 Power Blasts. No, it was 10 wins, because it was 10 wins. I went 10 and 3 with my 3 Power Blasts that each cost 10 and do 10 damage. Ooh, legendary. This card sucks. This looks like it sucks. Also, yeah. I don't know, maybe he's cool. We have 2 legendaries so far. I don't want to press space, I want to do this. It's more fun. Alright, alright. Ooh, gold. I'm not getting like any of the cards to build the decks that I want to build. I kind of want to build Druid. Druid seems sweet. I guess a lot of the cards for that deck are like basic cards though, so. Ooh. Epic. This guy seems pretty good. I got two Wraths at least. Alright, I think I have the two Druid of the Claws. I don't even know what I would actually want to put in that deck, but Druid seems sweet. Whoa. Ooh, gold. Gold is good for disenchanting. Lame, lame, lame. Crunch. Boom. There was a big boom there. Does that mean I opened a legendary or something? No. It seemed like an especially big boom. Boom. Ooh, a Warlock, a Murloc guy. Lame, lame, lame. Lame, lame, lame. Only three packs left. Only one good card. Ooh, a gold card. Come on. Come on, boom. Ooh, an epic. Alright. So, I guess let's go to my collection now. I guess first thing I want to do is, like, disenchant all my extras. So, boom, disenchant extra cards. Get out of here. Boom. I have 900 and something arcane dust. So... I mean, I guess I can disenchant a bunch of stupid golds too. That'll get me a bunch of hair. How do I show only golden cards? Get out of here. Boom. Boom. Get out of here. That's actually a pretty good card, I don't want to disenchant it. Nah, I would kind of hold on to that one, that one's kind of sweet too. Ooh, so many gold cards, this card's kind of sweet. Get out of here. Oh, I can't, come on. Get out of here. Did I get... Was that like the thing, only the like new ones or something? It must have been. Ooh. Get out of here. Alright, so... Alright, well... So I have 1920 dust. And... Alright, let's go. Let's leave crafting mode. So what are you gonna make? I don't really know what I want to make. I don't know what like a sweet deck I can make is. Yeah, it seems like I could kind of make like a shaman deck. Shaman actually seems kind of sweet. Feral Spirit's kind of sweet. This guy actually seems kind of sweet. Oh, new deck. Shaman. Choose. Alright, now we're making a shaman deck, I guess. Let's get some... I don't really know. I do have a Leroy. I really don't like the Miracle Rogue deck. I think it's like super lame. I tried playing it on my friend's account and just did not really enjoy it. It's not the sort of game I like to play. What do I got? Ooh, knife jugglers seem kind of sweet. I only have one knife juggler. This guy's sweet. Alright, let's get some lightning bolts in here. Is Earthshock good? Earthshock seems kind of good. Alright, let's get some fire elementals in here. Flaming Totem seems like it'd be kind of good. Earthshock seems pretty good. Mana Tide Totem doesn't seem very good. My friend's deck had Mana Tide Totem in it, and I didn't really like it. I always hated it when I drew it. It made me very annoyed. I don't have... Well, no, I do have Rockwater Weapon's good, I think. Is Hex good? I'll play Hex. Knife Juggler seems sweet because you have totems. But you just could tell you know, between totems and Feral Spirit, Knife Juggler seems really good. I kind of feel like I want another Knife Juggler. Sure, I'll play a Lava Burst. I'll play one Lava Burst. Come out one Bloodlust. Bloodlust seems kind of sweet. Alright, what generic dudes do I want? Like, the common decks are, like, what? They're, like, the Warlock deck, the Warlock, like, you know, Zoo-type deck, the Rogue deck. I mean, this seems like more of a control-style deck than a Leroy deck. Leroy actually seems kind of bad in this deck, but... Azure Drake sounds good. Do I have Azure Drakes? I do. I have one Azure Drake. I'll play my Azure Drake. Senjin Shieldmaster? Sure, I'll play him. 1-1 Divine Shield guy. That guy seems okay, I guess. It seems like I have a lot of stuff that costs 3. To play Harvest Golem. I have Unbound Elemental and Feral Spirit and Hex. I guess I have a ton of overload, so like my curve's gonna always be weird. I guess I'll play one Harvest Golem, because I have one Harvest Golem. I feel like I want either Shieldmaster or Yeti. Yeti doesn't seem... I feel like this deck wants Shieldmaster because it wants to kind of be defensive. Maybe I don't have enough good late game to be defensive, though. I'll throw some Yetis in here. So yeah, my deck is very, very heavy at 3, not particularly at 2. I guess I'll play that one Manatide Totem as my last card. I only have Fire Elemental. I have nothing that actually costs more than 6. I don't own a Ragnaros. Should I make a Ragnaros? Ragnaros does seem sweet. Yeah, it seems like I do want, like, Auctioneer. Auctioneer seems like he could be sweet in this deck. I have a lot of spells. Lava Burst seems... what did I just take out? Oh god. I took out something I probably didn't mean to. I took out Manatide Totem. We'll play one Auctioneer. Oh yeah, I have this guy. Oh, no, I don't want to actually play him. Sea Giant. Eh, I'll play a Sea Giant. Sure. I have a bunch of stuff that makes guys. Extra guys, I have totems. We'll try a Sea Giant. Alright. I'm gonna play this deck. We'll try it. We'll play. Sure, I'll play ranked. Whatever. Boom. Boom, let's go. Alright, so I feel like I probably want to... My opponent's a mage. I have no idea what mage decks have. I feel like I just want to mulligan all of these. I don't really have any early plays. None of these seem... Maybe I want to keep like a lightning bolt. Meh, I'm just going to mulligan everything. I have no idea what his deck does. Alright, this looks better already. Get him, Totem. Get him. Harvest Golem, go. I know I like Harvest Golem from Arena. He's always sweet. Coin into Yeti. Eat Hex Yeti. I could just Rockbiter this guy, actually. I think that's maybe better. Rockbitering this guy, hitting the Yeti, and playing an Unbound Elemental. That seems better. Maybe he has bigger things. I can, like, hex it, but this seems stronger to me. Like, he could have, like, some sort of thing that's, you know, better than Yeti that I need to hex. Let's do it. Oh, I accidentally took a Lightning Storm out of my deck? Well, that seems dumb. Certainly shouldn't have done that. I should fix that after this game. Swing and a miss! Ooh, oh god. I kinda wanna double up my value on these guys. You are in the mix with us, Tritonal here on Tritonia, another fun matchup for the dance floor. This one coming from Astro. I'm just gonna play this. Don't wanna play that? Next turn I'll have six. I can either Flame Tongue to hit him for an extra two. I think I'd rather just make a totem here. I mean, I can play Unbound and Flame Tongue, or I can play Unbound and Totem. I think I probably just want to... I guess I might as well Totem. This hits him, like, really, really hard next turn. When I feral spirit. I can, like, even feral spirit hex. Whoa, a storm, a knight. Oh shit. Is this my first time playing Hearthstone? No, it's my first time playing Constructed in Hearthstone. I've played a lot of Arena in Hearthstone, but I've never actually played Constructed before. So I can Rockbiter this guy, kill that guy, hit him for... Hit him for 8. If he flame strikes me, I'm fine. He's actually just dead. I have three different guys who survive flame strike right now. He's actually not dead, but almost dead now. Ooh, hi. You're now at one. Go. Man down. Getcha. Actually, I want to hit you as hard as possible to kill you. I have gotten an additional star. Alright. Win one. Cool. Alright, so we actually want to fix my deck now and get that lightning storm in. So I want to take out... I don't know what I take out. Boy, I know we want that lightning storm. I don't know. I don't know what I take out. Everything seemed good. Yeah, I played a bunch of Arena. I mean, I opened 55 packs just now. I'm like level 30 Mage, level 28 Paladin, level 25 Shaman or whatever. I don't want to take out Axe. Axe seems sweet. Yeah, I'm actually going to take out Sea Giant. Sea Giant actually seems like it's not that good. Like, that game, it was, you know, probably about the best it could be, and it wasn't even, you know, if I have a ton of guys in play, I'm already in really good shape, I think. So, alright, let's go back to play mode. Boom. Alright, so Hunter, I feel like Manatide Totem probably sucks, because I'm on the draw and Hunter decks are probably typically pretty aggressive. Hex seems okay, Knife Juggler seems good, Right Quarter Weapon seems good, so. Tracking out of nowhere. I kind of want to coin out Knife Juggler, then I can Rockbiter attack whatever he plays next, then I can Wolves the next turn, so I'm going to do that. Not sure if that's good, but... feels good. Chain shot. What a jerk. Man down. River Croc. Okay. I'm gonna play my Unbound Elemental and say go, I think. I could... Rockbiter, kill that, make another totem. That doesn't seem any good, though. Yeah, I'm just gonna play him. Ho! Monkey see, monkey do. So I can, if I Feral Spirit, the next turn I still only have three, and this guy doesn't actually even kill this, so it's actually not even that exciting. I could just attack there and play Chill Wind, which might just be best. Yeah, I'm just gonna attack there and play Chill Wind. I mean, I'm playing at rank 25, so my opponents are very unlikely to be playing particularly sophisticated and tuned decks that you know are whatever metagame type decks. So, you know, I imagine most people who are at rank 25 have substantially less experience playing TCGs than I do. So, all right. So I can kill this guy. I can attack this guy, then I can Rockbiter my hero, attack that guy, and play Feral Spirits if I want. I could just play Earth Elemental, but he can kill that. He has 7, 8, 9. So it feels like this is probably better. Oh my god, gold wolves. Whoa, I wish I had more lightning storms. Why do I play Chill Wind Yeti and Shaman? Because I was building a deck and looking at the cards that I had, and it was one of them. It's not a particularly complicated reason. Alright, let's kill this guy, let's hit you. Let's Rockbiter me. Kill this guy. Play Harvest Golem. You can get golden totems? Jeez. Oh god. Must hex. Actually, I don't have to hex it. I can just do this. I do have one Defender of Argus that I could put in this deck. You're getting earth-shocked. $500 wins with that class, wow. That's a lot of wins. Kill that guy. I'm just gonna 12 you. I feel safe. I feel very safe. I haven't shot. I've been shot. We are victorious. All right. I've gotten a second star. Battle next. I wonder how many wins I have in any of the classes. I really have no idea. Am I allowed to drink soda in my diet? This is Coke Zero, so it's not really, you know, terrible for dieting or whatever. It's probably best not to, but I do. All right, I'm just gonna mulligan all of these since I'm first, and they all cost a lot of mana. I've given up caffeine many times in my life, and I have every time failed, so. Whoa! This is a serious beatdown. My opponent is going very aggro. How much do competitive Hearthstone decks cost? I don't really know. Whoa, this guy. I don't even like that guy in draft. But we're gonna kill him. Yeah, he was getting something started with that arcane shot. That reminds me of a game where like LSV was playing in a Magic draft, and his opponent just like, you know, oh god, I got multi-shotted. That was pretty rude. Did I not attack? Oh, I didn't attack. I'm just dumb. I'm the worst. I was too busy talking about my opponent's arcane shot to attack myself. Whoa, Goldshire Footman. I will raise Goldshire Footman. Next turn I'm gonna Lightning Storm, it's gonna be glorious. Maybe I'm not, but. All of your beasts have plus one attack. You need some beasts, though. I would not make that attack if I were you. Oh my god, man, if I told him I'm going off. I am going off. I'm actually not fidgeting with anything right now, which is incredibly unusual for me. Normally I'm always like fidgeting with something at any given time. People in the chat saying, you know, hunters don't use 7 plus cost minions. I'm like, this one might. My last opponent played Corehound. Seems like I could you know, save my stuff here. All right, I could Earthshock this guy and then Lightning Bolt him. Or I can Hex him. I feel like I just want to Earthshock Bolt him. So I get to hit him for a ton of damage. I'm going to do that. You guys fidget with the statues in the corner, but statues. I mean, hit this guy. You didn't hit this. Look, a Corehound! I told you, people! I told you! I am so vindicated. The glory that is my big game hunter killing his Corehound like I said it would. Yeah, Unleash the Hounds would be pretty good. It would be pretty good if I had a Bloodlust here, but I don't have Bloodlust in my deck. I'm just gonna launch rocks at him. Can my opponent see me launching rocks at him? Because if he can't, it really makes it way less... way less exciting. I guess my opponent was always on the side that has the catapult, huh? You always see yourself in the bottom, so you'll never actually see your opponent launching rocks at you. We have defeated him. Boom! Bonus star! We're now a leper gnome. I earned 10 gold. I am rich. See, I don't, like, while I can see Leroy plus Windfury being, like, good to end games, it doesn't really feel, like, I feel like I'd rather just have individually powerful cards. Like, this seems like the sort of deck that wants to be more of just, like, a, you know, good stuff mid-range type deck. I want to keep my Earth Elemental because he's great. We're gonna juggle some knives. So here. Oh, I drew a Yeti, so I actually don't wanna play Axe and kill his guy. Probably didn't. If I didn't have Yeti, I wanted to, you know, play Axe, kill. Ooh, that's a pretty good one. So I'm, you know, able to just be on curve for Earth Elemental, but now I can just play Yeti next turn instead. You're awake. I don't know. What are you gonna do? Whoa, to the face. To the face. I actually kind of want to play this instead of this because I want to keep my knife juggler alive. I'm going to play it first. Actually, I should have attacked that first. That was dumb of me. Oh well. Oops. I should have attacked that guy first. So there's a higher chance that it actually hits that guy. That was a mistake on my part. So I guess 50% chance, you know, because if it does hit this guy, then I can just hit his face for 3. Which is, like, you know, kind of fine anyway. Whoa, Nightbladed. Resolves. Charge? How rude. Still can't attack anything that doesn't have Protector. It was Protector in WoW TCG, which is why I constantly call it Protector. Ooh, god, a Manaphy Totem. Shoot his guy, come on. Yes. Value! I feel like I need more late game stuff. Maybe, you know, there's just like sufficiently powerful stuff anyway, but Earth Elemental is pretty powerful. Fire Elemental is powerful. What do I want? Maybe, like, I feel like I do want something like a Ragnaros. Ragnaros seems like it'd be sweet. Are you dead? If I hex your guy, Earth Shock it. If I just Earth Shock your guy, are you dead? One damage to a minion? 10? No, I can't do 17 to you. It's very unlucky. I guess I'll hex your guy. Then I can Earth Shock it, and then I can play Axe. That doesn't really do anything. 10. Actually, no, if I Earth Shock it now, and I Rock Butter me, I can do 13. No, 13, 14, 15. I can do 15. I'm gonna try and shoot his guy. Alright, cool. You have 5 hounds. He is almost dead, that Earth Elemental, almost dead. Now, sir, it is you who are dead. Alright, I'm going to take a quick break to run to the restroom and chat with Natalie now that she's awake. I'm going to run a quick commercial, so don't go anywhere. We'll be back to continue our rising in the ranks. Ooh, we are, what are we? What are we now? It didn't even tell me I'm something different. Anyway, I'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. Alright, I'm back. Dun 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 dun, play. Yeah, if you do have ad block, I can appreciate that. But I would also appreciate it if you turn off ad block while you're watching my stream, or put my stream on your whitelist or whatever it is. Because if you watch without ad block, I receive no fractions of a penny that I would receive. So, all right. So my opponent is playing priest. I'm just gonna keep my unbound elemental and mulligan my earthshocks because unbound elemental is sweet. Well, I have my lightning storm. I feel like I drew more Earthshocks anyway. I feel like I want more spell damage stuff to go with lightning storm. I want another lightning storm. I want blood mage Thalnos, I think, and I want another azure drake. I think those are the cards that like I feel like would improve my deck from what I've seen. I'm an Argent Squire. I am truly mighty. Truly, truly mighty. Oh, well, there's one of them. All right. Totem it is. Malagos seems like he costs too much. I feel like Azure Drake and Blood Mage Thalnos cost, you know, an amount that is reasonable. He has Shadowworn Pained my totem. He got me good. I mean, one of the things that I think is actually pretty fascinating about you know, playing at this sort of this level of competition in Hearthstone to me, you know, as someone who pretty much has exclusively played games in competitive environments for, you know, 20 years more or less. Is like that, you know, like it's very easy to be like, oh my god, I can't believe he'd make that play, but like you only would not make that play if you sort of understand the fundamentals of like, you know, magic strategy, like card advantage and you know, things like that. It's just like, oh, he's a guy, I can kill it, I'm gonna play it. That's just like the way that people think about things when they think about games a lot of times. They're just like, he is a guy I can kill with my thing, I'm gonna use my thing to kill it. And it's very easy for, you know, experienced players to, you know, criticize that kind of play and be like, oh my god, I can't believe you'd do that. But like, you know, when you are an inexperienced player, you know, that's just not, you don't, just don't think about things in quite the same way. And one of the things that's pretty amazing about Hearthstone is how many people it has brought into the card gaming space who are not previously card gamers. I mean, I'm sure the number of, you know, the people who I'm playing ranking up from 25 right now have not played collectible games competitively for 20 years. Like, it is pretty unlikely. Oh god, poor guy. He's gonna get Earthshocked. Earthshocked into the Stone Age. Earthshock you into the Stone Age. Stormforge Axe, Feral Spirit. Speaking of the Stone Age. My board is pretty good right now compared to him. we need new music. So next, Tritonia. This is actually the previous one. By next, I mean last. Yeti hype. I have 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. I have 17 damage and ways to break through any number of... I always am going to say protectors. I'm never going to say taunts. I was literally... Any ways to break through is protectors. Yeah, they were protectors in WoW TCG. I'm going to say protector forever, I'm sure. So I have 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Will Lightning Storm for good measure. All right. Boom, boom. Another bonus star. So many bonus stars. We are ranked 22. My opponent is a warlock. Ooh, he's level 21. I go first. I will mulligan my expensive cards. Alright, well I have a bolt and a knife juggler and a hex. Bolt your face. No. It's tempting, but no. Am I playing to a set amount of wins or until I want to stop? I'm just playing until I feel like stopping, really. Probably until Natalie decides that we're going to dinner. Or something similar. Uh-oh, my opponent seems like he might have a real deck. Oh god, a real deck. Okay. Maybe I want to just... Okay, now I guess I have to think now. I probably just Earthshock a guy. I could just Earthshock and Lightning Bolt. That ends up overloading me, which is probably fine. I feel like the weird thing is, this is actually one of the things that I dislike the most about Hearthstone are hero powers, because they define the game just out from something outside of the cards that are actually being played in the game. Like, if you want to try and play an attrition game, that's one of the reasons that I imagine the Warlock constructed aggro decks are successful, is because they can, you can basically never just attrition them out if you're not also racing them. So we're definitely going to Earthshock a guy. The question is whether we also Lightning Bolt a guy. Probably just Lightning Bolt him too. Alright, so now I can just play a knife juggler on my overloaded turn here. Mortal Coil, what a jerk. Alright, well, he has no board. I mean, I get, like, I get some amount. Ooh, well, I don't want to do that now because I want to be able to play Azure Dink next turn, so I'm just going to make a totem. Okay, well, he is not a particularly refined Warlock deck if he has this card in it, I don't think. So, I don't really just want to play Azure Drake to get killed. Maybe it doesn't matter. Maybe it's fine. If he's trading his board presence with my guy who drew a card, I'm pretty happy with that anyway. Shadowbolt, okay. Oh boy. For those asking the chat, I did in fact open the packs. Mortal Coil again for my guy. If I flame tongue here, I can just kill. Yeah, let's do this. Well, I think the Omegatrion or whatever, I definitely think the old TCG powers were very bad too. I mean, I was one of the designers of that game and I argued against them existing in the way that they did. Alright, well, another Yeti's kind of sweet. I feel like I don't want to take damage on this Yeti. I think I'd rather this Rockbiter me. If I Rockbiter me and hit that, I guess I could rock. I guess I could also Stormforge, attack this, then attack it, Rockbiter this, attack that, hit this, and play Chillwind there. Maybe that's the best. Totally clears his board, and I'm left with two full health Yetis. That seems good. He's already played two Mortal Coils, so this guy being at one health isn't, like, particularly bad for me either. He has so many cards in his hand. Warlock. So rude. That was pretty bad. Yeah, at least I got the hit out of that, though. These guys didn't take any damage, and that's exactly what I wanted to do, is keep my Yetis at full health, so that they didn't die to something like that. I didn't attack with my Yeti? God damn it! I keep just not attacking with my creatures. I'm a master. I am a master, ladies and gentlemen. He should be at 5. Yeah, that's actually really bad. If I just miss 6 damage. Boulder Fist Ogre. Well, he should be dead now, basically, so. And now he's a Boulder Fist Ogre. I'm probably dead. No, you need to have. Get another attack! Alright, well, I guess I'll play that now. That didn't work how I think you wanted it to. Yeah, he'd actually just be dead if I just attacked with my guy. Hopefully I just, like, you know, draw, I don't know, Fire Elemental now or something. And he has nothing. Feral Spirit seems pretty good. So he'd be dead if I hadn't just, you know, not attacked. Sivensoul, no! Oh god. The worst possible for me. Whoa. Oh, he's gonna. Holy shit! Exploded me. Alright, that was my first loss to literally just not attack it with my creature. Let's try to do better than that. Let's try to, you know, actually attack with our creatures. DJ Nemesis. Alright, I'm gonna mulligan the expensive cards and keep my Feral Spirits. Whoa, yeah, you guys are... I have a demonic number of viewers right now. Oops. He has... Oh, saying... I did get Leroy in my second pack, but I only got like one other thing since then. Uh-oh, Wild Growth. Well, an Unbound Elemental is sweet. I have multiple overloads. Yeah, I didn't mean go away. I meant, you know, we clearly need more viewers now that. So I kind of don't want to play this guy when he has this in the board, when I can't actually trigger it. So I think I actually just want a Feral Spirit right now. I don't just want to throw this away to his Jungle Panther. I don't know if that's right. I'm just going to Feral Spirit. I would be playing Wild Growth if I had like cards to make a Druid deck, but I don't. It seemed like I had the most sort of relevant cards to build a reasonable Shaman deck. So I could Rockbiter or play Flame Tongue and trade both my totems for his guy. I think Flame Tonguing seems better. And trading both my totems for his guy. Rather than trading Rockbiter and my guy. Or my totem and my dude. Alright, he's just killing my totem, that's pretty cool. I'm gonna go Unbound Totem this turn, and then I'm gonna Fire Elemental the next turn. Or maybe I Rockbiter kill that guy. I think I'm gonna Unbound and Rockbiter and kill that guy. So now I have Fire Elementals online, and I'm gonna have two Unbounds with Stormforge X to play. Alright, he's just swiping my guy, that's fine. Is someone in my chat really saying, why would anyone with skill play Zoo? Really? You must not play Magic, you must not know who I am. I disagree that I wanted to play Weapon there. I wanted to Rockbiter because I wanted to be, didn't want to be overloaded for this turn. I want to be able to play Fire Elemental. Alright, now we're going to play this guy and a totem. Alright, so this guy we can... Alright, well, Hex changes things. I can Hex this guy, and then... Well, I kind of just want to play Fire Elemental too, though. If I Earthshock this guy, then he doesn't lose his plus two, plus zero, whatever, but... I also kind of want to save Hex for, like, a huge guy. So I think I kind of just want to do this. Yeah, this seems best. I still have this going. I still have Hex, Earthshock, Axe in my hand, so... Like, if he plays some giant legendary, I still have a lot of good action to kill it. Or that. Spooky. So... I'm tempted to hex that guy, play five, hex that guy, play axe, or just, I guess I could just hex that guy, play Azure Drake, attack it. Yeah, let's just do this. Because we also have Earthshock for some crazy legendary too. Yeah, I've been more impressed by Manatide and the way these games have been going. Granted, when I was playing Manatide Totem before, I was playing against decks that were just actually much more impressive. My opponents right now are just not playing particularly good decks. It seems like Manatide is probably very, very good against decks that aren't that good. Alright, so we're going to play Stormforge X, Earth Elemental, attack that guy. Attack you, attack you, attack you, play this, your turn. Okay, I'm pretty sure you're still dead. I have like a trillion damage. Alright. Boom. Murloc Raider, 10 gold, we're rich. Alright, I'm gonna take a quick break to run to the bathroom. Don't go anywhere, we'll be back to continue. What are we? We're not even a Murloc Raider anymore. We're a South Sea deckhand or whatever. But I'll be right back. Don't go anywhere, we'll continue to battle and hopefully remember to attack with our creatures. I have returned bearing Shiro. I have 6 out of 500 wins. All right, we're on our way. On the draw, I'm gonna guess Big Game Hunter's probably not very good against this deck. I don't know why I think that, but it's probably not very good early at least. Maybe it's just a dude I can play early, but I have no idea what a priest deck might look like. I'm just gonna keep a hex because hex seems generally pretty good. Shiro, you're freaking out. Don't freak out. Kind of hot in here. I think Shiro is uncomfortable. Shiro! Alright. Oh yeah, Shadow Word Death and Shadow Word Pain are a good reason to keep this. Alright, we'll go with this. Alright, Shiro wants to go down. Shiro's not having any of this. But yes, you can use the BMK Shiro mode if you're a subscriber to my channel. And you'll get to hang out with Shiro all the time. Well, not all the time, but when he's on the channel and doesn't decide to run away. But we probably need to turn the air conditioning on because it's very hot in here. What? Thank you. So I could just coin out a Big Game Hunter to give some beatdowns. I have very little experience, you know, playing constructed in general in this game. So I don't really entirely know, you know, the value of the coin against in various matchups and various decks and stuff. I know that when I'm playing Arena, I usually just, you know, coin to get sort of tempo in the way that I want my turns to play out. And in this case, for instance, using the coin to play this gives me a dude. But I don't, like, they have, like, Holy Smite, which is 2. I don't know if they actually play those cards or whatever, so I'm probably just going to, end my turn. Oh, by end my turn, I mean I should have made a totem, but, you know, we're getting to not forgetting to use things in the next lesson. Hero powers are way too tough, man. So, Shadow Word Death kills Earth Elemental. So I kind of just want a Feral Spirit. Although, that means I can't play Auctioneer next turn. I could just Auctioneer right now. And then next turn, I can, like, Feral Spirit Lightning Bolt. I think I'm just going to Auctioneer right now. Now, like, next turn I can theoretically, like, Bolt, Hex, Feral Spirit, or whatever, and just get a bunch of cards with Auctioneer. Yeah, who needs totems? Come on. What a jerk, he silenced it. So I kind of don't want to overload here because I want to play this next turn. Maybe that doesn't matter. Maybe I just want to overload this turn and then I can play something else, you know, future turn. I don't really have a good four. Don't write something as a title if I don't do that. I was opening all my packs, and then I made decks. Those things actually tend to happen in consecutive order because one is not possible without the other. So that's why my title says that. All right. We want gold spirits. I suppose I should have used this first since I was going to do it anyway, and then maybe I don't spirit if I get that, but... Mind games? Whoa! What do you get? You got a Manatide Totem! What a jerk! Okay, I will change my title. It is now playing my first ranked Hearthstone matches with free-to-play Shaman. Though it actually, there, it updated, okay. Alright, all of my 55 packs were from Arena. I spent $3 during the beta, and, ooh, hi, Big Game Hunter, how are you? Let's hang out. We'll be friends. Yeah, let's play Golem. So, you know what's happened to me before when I was playing Shaman in Arena? Lame. I had my board entirely full of like just totems and dopey creatures and couldn't play anything else. Whoa. Get to Bruin. Man down. Man down. Face you, face you, face you. Curses, my guy's dead. Good thing I never wasted playing my Earth Elemental. Ooh, that guy doesn't do anything since you're already in Shadow Form, really. I think you're dead? I have 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, yes. Boom, boom, boom. All right. We are still rank 21. Keeping going. Keeping going. We have still only lost a game to forgetting to attack, so a good start so far. All right, against Druid, Earth Elemental, what, we're in the play. Earth Elemental is probably pretty good against Druid. What do they have? They don't really have, they like naturalize, but they won't really play it. I'm gonna just hide my Earth Shock. Ooh, all feral spirits all the time. Lightning bolts you. Healing totem, all right. Novice engineer. Okay, so he's probably put, if he's playing a, you know, reasonable deck, the chance of, you know, playing novice engineer probably means he's playing the Savage Roar deck. So we're gonna start with our gold feral spirit because it's better than the other one. It is true that I am very old and that I have gray hair. I am 33, and you can see it right here. There's my gray hair. I don't know, it's right there, like a patch. Big patch, like right in the middle. Earthbound is weak against druids because they have Black Knight and Big Game Hunter. That's good to know. That's relevant information that I did not have. All right, well, we're gonna play this. We're gonna kill your guy. We're gonna hit your face. And we're gonna heal up. Boom, so Swiperino doesn't kill my guy. Yeah, I mean, when you're playing at like the rank 20s or whatever, I'm sure that the majority of people who you're playing against are not playing like constructed decks with whatever lists from whatever stuff on the internet. It's just like, it's, you know, like FNM, I'm sure. Savage Roar. Attack my guy. Nothing. Okay. Well, then I'm going to get you. I'm just going to play my Earth Elemental. This song's really good, I'm turning it up. I mean, I could play Earth Elemental, or I could just play, like, Unbound and a Totem. And then if I play Unbound and a Totem, then I play Earth Elemental next turn, I can play Earth Elemental Lightning Bolt or whatever and make my Unbound even bigger. Kind of just want to make my Unbound. I'm gonna put him here. Actually, no, I kind of want to be able to suicide that for value. Yeah, if you do Too Big to Fail, if you do Google me because of the Austin Angel of Despair thing, there are people with their theories that you know, have decided that I'm the devil. Ooh, speaking of, all right, so we can, oh god, I have so much action. So I can Lightning Bolt him, play Axe. Oh, he's just conceding. Oh, I was gonna blow him out so bad. I was gonna bolt him, attack with that. Oh, we are a shield bearer. I don't know who the real impact is, but hello, the real impact. Card back unlocked. Ooh, I can have different card backs. Yeah, how is rank 20 a 0/4? Like, especially if it's like supposed to be something sweet. Alright, a priest again. Alright, I feel like I just want to mulligan all of my cards. Azure Drake seems sweet. I kind of want to keep an Azure Drake. This is called Superhuman, this song. It is, Juventa. Oh god, my hand is so expensive. Oh god, I wish I had that thing that I mulliganed. Rockbiter. I feel like I'm gonna lose now. My hand is too bad. My hand is so bad! I'm gonna play Harvest Golem though. My hand costs 1,000 mana. He's gonna kill it, and then he's gonna kill that and draw a card. Maybe not. Oh god. Oh, and it's even worse for me. Now I have this Manatide Totem in my hand. Sick draw. All right. Well, we're gonna play Manatide Totem and cycle. Whoa, I've been thought stolen. What a jerk. If this is not going to do anything in this turn, maybe I can win. Yeti. 4 power Yeti. Suck it, Shadow Words. I'm not saying that Shieldbearer isn't a good card in the game. I'm saying it's just unimpressive as like a thing to be. Like if you're just like, you know what you can be? You can be a 0-4. Like, in particular for... Oh, God. He stole my Flame Tongue Totem! What the hell? What a dick! Alright, well, I'll play an Azure Drake. That has a lot of health now. Guy's dead. Jeez. Now that my Azure Drake's dead, that was bad for me. Let's kill this. Oh god. He's drawing so many extra cards. I feel so jealous. But this is actually pretty good for me, I think. I now have 2 Fire Elementals to his nothing on board, and I have a big Game Hunter in hand if he does play something like Ragnaros or whatever. All right. Kind of just want to trade off with this and then hit this, like, and then play these two. I have so many expensive, like, relatively powerful expensive cards in my hand that, like, it feels like I'm actually in pretty good shape if the game goes long, so. I could say, like, Holy Nova or something, but, like, I feel like leaving him with these guys is probably bad for me, so I'm just gonna kill them. He's restoring a lot of health. He's got a theme deck. A restore health theme deck. Alright, well, I'm gonna trade off. Do I want to trade off? I don't really know. Yeah, mind control. I don't want to get mind controlled. I agree with that. Just. But if he does mind control, if he, like, if I play Earth Elemental mind control, then I can just big game Hunter it. So. I kind of just want to trade here. And then just hit him. Well. I'm just going to spam the board with stuff and make these guys big. This also makes both of these guys 4 power, so we can't use either Shadow Word on them. You can Shadow Word this guy, but then I both these guys are unshadow wordable. If he does have mind control, I can big game Hunter. There we go. Yep, I can big game Hunter that. That's fine. I had a plan, you see? Oh god. Alright, well, big game Hunter, kill that. Now, the world is 4 power. Every single creature I control is 4 power. What do you think about that, Priest? What do you think about that? I hope you had a handful of nothing but Shadow Words. Oh god, I'm rank 19. I'm a novice engineer. 100 gold earned for winning 3 games in play. Oh no. What did I get? I don't know. I will play again.
Okay, I'll go there.
Okay. Alright, this is my last game. We're going to dinner after this game, so we're gonna make this game count. I don't know if the other games. The other games also, I think, counted. But I'm going first. I kind of like Mana Tide Totem seems kind of sweet against a lot of decks I played. I kind of just want to mulligan my hex. Now I lose stars if I lose a match. Well, I'm just not gonna do that then. Why would I lose matches? Oh, there's my hex that I just mulliganed. Today is the first day I've ever played ranked games of Hearthstone. This is the first deck I've ever built. I played a bunch of Arena and built a deck, and now I'm playing some ranked games. Very first deck. Mana Tide is soft, a Lightning Bolt, and Rock Biter. I do have Feral Spirit in my hand, though. I'm not just going to play a naked Mana Tide, but I have Feral Spirit, which makes it fairly attractive to me. As I said on Twitter, I don't always forget to attack or use my hero power, but when I do, I'm usually streaming. Totem time! End turn time! Ooh. Is my opponent just not taking his turns? This is the least satisfying last game ever. My opponent is actually just not taking his turns. He is too scared. Too scared of me. He's actually just not here. My opponent's just AFK. This is the least satisfying game I've ever played. But oh, look, the card's moving in his hand. Looks like he's doing something. All right. Well, maybe he's just like a true Hearthstone pro and is just deciding to give me a chance. Yeah, now he just knows that I'm you know, in a rush to go to dinner and wants to be kind. I wonder. I also wonder. All right. Well, we'll play Manitai Totem because we want to draw more cards. Even if our opponent's doing nothing, we want to draw cards. Like the animation of the cards moving in his hand is actually supposed to be them actually looking at them, right? That's what I thought. Because I know, like, when there's, like, you know, they're hovering over stuff, that's like indicative of whatever. All right. Well. Guys, I think we might have this one. He's discarding. He actually just played a card! He actually was just sitting here and waiting to play that! He's been here the whole time! I think he's dead anyway, so. No, he actually goes to one. Alright, well. We were able to get past his clever ploy to make a giant guy on turn six. When we'd actually just done something, but. Alright, so that's gonna be it for this particular stream. Thank you all for coming and watching. My first experience with Hearthstone Constructed, we managed to go 10-1. If we discount games in which we simply did not attack with a minion for no reason, we were undefeated. I'm gonna go to dinner. I may play some more when I get back. If not, I'm gonna be playing more, over the next however long. I have started to enjoy playing Hearthstone Constructed. I had some fun today. I had some fun the last time I played it at my friend's house. So we'll see how if we can make any sweet decks and try and grind up those ranks. The grinding isn't very fun. I want to actually just somehow stay on some sort of win streak and be like rank 2 in 30 minutes. But anyway, thanks for watching. If you enjoy the stream, be sure to follow so you get notified when I go live. Or you can always follow me on Twitter. My Twitter handle is right below the webcam, right there. BM Kibler on Twitter, same as the channel name. Follow me, I always tweet when I go live as well. And if you particularly like the stream, you can always subscribe. Obviously, no requirement to do so, but I appreciate it, helps support the stream. And, gets you the free, or the super cool Shiro emote that you saw in the chat earlier. So anyway, I'm gonna spam some BMK Shiros before I go. And I'll see you later. Thanks for watching. Bye.